Even though he's portrayed as a jerk, I don't think Ging is actually a bad father. Due to the fact that for the majority of Gon's life, Ging was away exploring the world, people tend to call him a bad father, but if we contextualize his actions and personality within the series, we may come to find out that he's a great father within the context of the Hunter x Hunter world. The main reason people call Ging a bad father is because he abandoned Gon, but I don't see it that way. He didn't abandon Gon. He left him with the person he figured would be best at raising him and developing a solid foundation within him so that he can reach his maximum potential within the Hunter x Hunter world. Mito essentially raised Ging, which helped develop his own foundation and prepare him to prosper within this world. I'm sure he saw things that way, and going off of how he turned out, wanted to give Gon the same experience. And on top of that, he knew he wouldn't be the best person for a young child to be around. Due to the fact that he gets bored easily, he wouldn't be able to fully devote himself and give the attention and nurturing that a young child needs, so he left that job to someone who could provide that. Even if he would have stayed around, his semi-presence and lack of affection would have led to Gon feeling neglected and unwanted, and wouldn't have allowed him to become the person he is. Thanks to Mito's single parenting, Gon now has a high level of intelligence and sense of self which he needs in order to prosper in this world. The main power system in Hunter x Hunter is Nen, which is powered by life force, but it also increases the greater the sense of self one has. It's safe to say that if Gon wanted to thrive in this world, he'd have to become very efficient with his Nen use. I don't think it's too far-fetched to assume that Ging, knowing his own origins, decided to put Gon through the same childhood that he experienced, so that his sense of self would rise, which would in turn make his potential for Nen use grow exponentially. And if this theory is correct, then Ging did the right thing, because not only is Gon a 1 in 10 million prodigy,
those two, however, are even rarer talents. Perhaps 1 in 10 million.
He also has potential to rival the Chimera Ant King Meduim himself. A being literally bred to be the pinnacle of all living things. Following this, it makes sense as to why Ging left a treasure hunt for Gon to go on in order to reach him. He was prepping Gon by having him follow the necessary steps to greatness. Ging knew that once Mito had raised Gon to a certain point, he would want to venture out into the world. He also knew that Gon would be interested in hunters, so that's why he left him clues on how to find him by having him become a hunter. Becoming a hunter would lead to Gon learning about Nen, which he would need in order to access the game Greed Island, a game Ging designed that allowed Gon to hone and master his Nen abilities to put him at a level far above the average Joe, a level he needed to be at in order to reach Ging. And even if he had help getting there, he'd still get sent to Kite, someone that's very close to Ging and also would provide him with whatever tools he'd be lacking in order to be ready to find Ging. This has to be the case because Ging makes it so Gon is able to reach him once the game is finished, meaning he knew Gon would play it and he also knew that Gon would be the one to win it. I mean, look, this doesn't sound like a guy who's unsure of what's going to happen.
So, can you make it so that using magnetic force will send Gon to me, while using a company will send him to Kite? One day, my son's going to come here. When he does, don't hold back.
Fine. Does that mean that I can kill him?
Don't underestimate him. He is my kid. I'm counting on you. Thanks, Razor.
He had absolute confidence in his child making it to him, because he wouldn't have wanted anyone else coming to see him based off of how he acts.
More people would just make you self-conscious, right?
And the only way he could have had that much confidence is if he planned all of this from the start. If not, then why do all this? If he really wanted to abandon him, why leave all these clues behind and cryptic messages that bring Gon closer to him and inadvertently guide him down the perfect path to becoming a powerful individual within this world? We know Ging isn't the type of person that does things he doesn't want to, so if he never wanted Gon, he never would have had him. And if he wanted to abandon him, he could have done a much better job at avoiding him. Honestly, Ging is like a father that works all the time to help provide for his family that the child doesn't see that often. Sure, that time spent together is more valuable than any material object, but you'd understand why a parent would do that in that context. Ging did the exact same thing, just with Nen and Nen abilities. And now that Gon's future is set to be as bright as possible and he's prepared to survive in the world Ging is exploring, they can spend more time together. After debunking the abandonment argument, there's really nothing showing that he's a bad father. He isn't emotionally or physically abusive to him. He isn't neglectful of his feelings as he helps Gon process Kite's quote-unquote death.
It's not fair! If anyone had to die, it should have been me!
Gon! That's not true. He underestimated the enemy. He just misjudged the enemy, that's all. Apologize!
and also properly helps him adjust to life without Ned. He doesn't even completely abandon him after being found, as he's interested in getting to know his son. So now Gon has a direct line of contact to Ging that he could probably use anytime. You can come to your own conclusions on whether or not you like the guy based off his contribution to the actual story, but that won't change the fact that he's done his job as a parent in prepping Gon for the future.